and that they are in need of God's grace. Now that sounds familiar, doesn't it? Christians are to be a confessing people, constantly living in repentance and authenticity so that we can be who we have been created to be. So each week, part of the confession they use, I'm just going to read a few lines, says, "Most merciful God, we have confessed that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves." So, you know, that last part, or that part in the middle, is what I want to concentrate on today. We as Christians, let's take the Catholics out of it now. We as Christians need to pay attention to that phrase, "by what we have left undone." You know, we're all guilty for things every day. Sometimes we swear. Some people steal. We have lust. We're selfish. We're not giving. But you know, Christianity or religion has become like an eraser. It's become like a guilt remover. But it should be a way of reminding ourselves of our constant need of grace, and not just remembering the bad things that we've done each day, but remember whose grace we are in need of today. That's what we need to do. And that's what I mean in this phrase, "by what we have left undone." You know, as we grow in our faith, and we start to realize what it means to follow Jesus, I think that we should slowly start to transition away from confessing all the bad things that we have done and move into doing the things that we ought to do. We start to realize, especially as we get older, that we're leaving too many things undone. You know, we need to pay attention. We need to cut to the heart of the matter. We kind of get stuck in the idea that Christianity is just a bunch of rules and traditions that we have to follow, and that confession or asking for forgiveness is the way we phrase it. I just tell them what I did wrong today and we'll start all over again tomorrow. We don't do anything about those things that we shouldn't do, other than just say, "I'm sorry. Sorry about those things. Won't do them again." Of course, we do them again. And that's one more minute of time. One more day of time that's taken away from us without doing things that actually should be done. And if we look at it this way, it makes our religion, makes us as Christians start to look a little bit different. It makes us start to wonder, well, what is it we should be doing? You know, that prayer that the Catholics use to start the confession says, you know, it reminds them that, hey, you know, we haven't loved God. We haven't treated our neighbors as they should be treated. We have not cared for the poor. We've not taken time to spend money on others other than ourselves. We have not gone out of our way to care for someone in need. So these are things that we leave undone. And all we do, and say, "I'm sorry," and do it again tomorrow. There's things that we should be doing as individuals, as a church, as a Christian community. We need to stop not wasting our time. I don't want you to get me wrong. We need to stop wasting our time for the things, bad or good, that we've done, and start doing those things that need to be done, that God calls us to get done. Most of us just don't do what we ought to do. We just avoid doing things for other people and helping take care of other people because there's always tomorrow, isn't there? You know that devil story. I maybe didn't even need to preach this sermon this morning because he said it right. The devil uses us against us because he has a way of reminding us, sometimes in a not so subtle way, that you got time, don't worry about it. You got time. Just go do what you want today and say you're sorry about it and maybe even do it tomorrow and the next day because you got time. Well, you know, I promised you that maybe we all live to be 150 in here today. Probably not going to happen. But we all, even as old as some of us are, we still think we have time. You know, the very night of our class reunion, we lost another one in our class. I'm sure she didn't plan on going. And I'm sure none of you are planning on going tonight or tomorrow or anytime soon. I know you want to come back and hear my sermon next Sunday. But we've got to start doing what we're called to do and not apologizing for what we've done. Jesus says, do unto others as you would have them do unto you. Okay, notice that Jesus didn't say, don't do things to others that you don't want to have done to you. So this goes beyond the command of just not to do things. Rather, it's a command calling us to action. A command for us to act with love and to serve others. So, when we confess our sin, or when we say, Lord, I'm sorry for our sin today, we need to also say, I'm sorry that I didn't use the time that you're giving me. I'm sorry that things are being left undone and mean it. Otherwise, it's just another way of saying, I'm sorry. You know, look how we deal with our husbands, our wives, our friends. Okay? You know, sometimes when you're married to a person for a long time, you kind of forget to say, you know, honey, you're really beautiful today. I love you so much. I remember the times. And I want to have more of those times. We just get so used to each other that it might be a week or two before, oh, I better say something to the wife today about how good she looks. Or I want to hear about it. How about all those friends that you used to have that you say, well, I'm going to call you up. I'm going to call Bill tomorrow. I'm going to call Betty tomorrow. I haven't seen him in a couple months, a couple years, a couple decades. And all of a sudden, you go to call that person, and someone answers on the other phone, I'm sorry, they passed away. How would you feel? That's leaving things undone that you should be doing. That's what I'm talking about. It's a simple message. God forbid if you do die tonight and you're going to come up to your maker tomorrow. What have you left undone? What should you have done? What could you? By the things we leave undone. one of the most important phrases I've heard in a long time. Do you know that things that we leave undone is actually sin? By leaving things undone, we're sinning. That's a little different take on things. There's a writer, James Keenan, that identifies this type of sin as the failure to bother to love. Powerful words. He says that this kind of sin, leaving things undone, is the very definition of what sin is. Have you ever thought about it like that? I have. Open my eyes. You know, look at story after story that Jesus, the stories that Jesus told. Jesus is always talking about those that claim righteousness by keeping the rules and not doing the wrong things. Jesus' concern is with those that could do something but choose to do nothing. Things left undone. How about the tax collector, the Pharisee here, the praying in the temple? The sin of the Pharisee is his strength. He specifically considers all that he has. And when the rich man, how about the rich man stepping over Lazarus at the gate and ignoring him? The rich man's sin is not in his weakness, but it's in his strength. He could have done something, but he did not. Things left undone. The steward, whose debt is forgiven by the master, but he turns around and he's punished because he doesn't forgive the minor debt of his own employee. Things left undone. In the end, the focus on all this is they could have acted, but they did not. We all, as individuals in a church, can act. But many of us choose not to. Many churches choose not to. Things left undone. Sometimes we sin out of our own strength and righteousness. I'm good. I've done what the Lord asked me to today. You know, I made my tithes. I went to church. I read the Bible. My strength is my weakness because I spent too much time talking about what I've done and no doing what I should have, could have done. You know, when you think about our faith this way, if we think about our faith as just being rules, being a body that gives us rules of the things that we cannot do, which many of us have heard this from childhood, our faith, instead of telling us what we cannot do, should be focusing on what we can do. So that we do not leave those things that we have left undone. When we apologize, when we ask for forgiveness for our sins, that should open our eyes immediately and remind us, let's just not do this again tomorrow. Probably some of us are going to, probably all of us are going to, but at least let's get something done in between the sinning. Don't waste that time. There's so much being left undone by Christians and so much left undone by the churches that claim to be Christian That's got to be changed. And so what I'd like to do today, because I could talk about this forever almost. I've been thinking about it all week. But I want to just do a simple prayer this morning that maybe will help us not to leave things like that. Will you please bow your heads in prayer? Lord, bend us. Lord, remove our apathy. Squash our selfishness so that we are free to love, so that we are able to give, so that we are strengthened to listen, so we become more like your Son. Let us not rest in our sin, satisfied by our confession. Let us be stirred to action, action that loves our enemies, action that cares for those who aren't like us, action that dies